guys, welcome back again to my channel. And yes, today I have another beautiful video to share with you guys. Today I'm gonna take you all the way to Guimaras Island. Guimaras Island is where I grew up and spent most of my childhood days. Most because like we also spent some of our childhood days and other parts of Philippines. But today I'm gonna introduce you to Guimaras Island. So Guimaras Island actually is one of the smallest province in Panay region. It's actually located in between Panay and Negros. Specifically, we are part of Iloilo. So our city is Iloilo. And you can access Guimaras from Iloilo through boat, that is a 15-minute ride. And also from Negros is also like Morobanca, like 1 hour or so. So that's a bit far. So that's why we're part of Iloilo. And so, as you can see here, I am at the Jordan Wharf. Guimaras has two wharves. One is in Buena Vista and this in Jordan. So basically, all the people departing Guimaras Island, after they bought their ticket, they were asked to write down the name, age, and address, you know, for preference, just in case purposes, you know what I mean, guys. And so yeah, this is the type of boat that we are using to transport us to Iloilo. As you can see, it is made of wood and plywood, and on both sides it has bamboo. Just maybe to balance it. I don't know how it works, but I think it's for balancing. And come on, you don't need to like be so. Anyway, the seat is in the middle, as you can see here, and we have life jackets. So just in case, again, the main focus of this video is about the healing tradition, which is called the tuob. Okay, but before we go that, I'm gonna invite you guys to come and visit Guimaras for Manggahan Festival. And also if you want to discover beach, we also have a lot of beaches there, guys. There's a lot, pristine clear blue water, white sand as well. So not only Barangay have the white sand beach, we also have farms like mushroom farms, grape farms. We have also the windmill farms. I know this is not a farm like plant, but we consider it as farm because like we are literally planting windmill there so that people will enjoy cheaper electricity cost. What else? Yeah, there's a lot of beautiful places to visit there, guys, in Guimaras. You can enjoy kite surfing. You can follow them actually in Instagram, Guimaras Kite Surfing. So yes, they don't know me and I don't know them personally, but I just saw it online. So yeah, I'm kind of like promote because it's from Guimaras. Yeah, you can enjoy it. That's one of the attraction. And also you can enjoy the floating cottage. So in the floating cottage, they actually offer you food there, and of course there are experienced swimmers to assist you, because literally this is in the middle of the ocean. And then you are allowed to go dive and swim, of course, with full equipment such as life jackets and other, you know, safety measures as well. So you can try that floating cottage as well. And yeah, most specifically the Manggahan Festival, guys, right? We don't forget the Manggahan Festival. Just go there and enjoy eating like mango. If you want, you can participate in Eat All You Can Mango for only 100 pesos. I think it's only more than $1, not even $2 US, I guess. So you can enjoy eating mangoes, maybe ripe or green, as per your liking. Eat as much as you want. You can enjoy also the pagtaltal and Balaan Bukid during Holy Week, where actually they reenact the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. And yeah, more of that, guys, later on. And if you want, you can also like see it on your booking.com, right? Your travel agencies as well, or you can simply search it up on Google as well. We are there. So let's talk about this actually, Gimarasnon. What are the common breakfasts of Gimarasnon? So as you can see here, I'm having boiled plantain bananas. They boil it ripe or like just simply mature one, but I prefer the mature one because if you boil the ripe one, it has a tendency to be a bit sour. So yeah, and then we pair it with coffee, or sometimes we also have bread. And most especially, some people, they like to eat breakfast with rice. They start up their breakfast with rice. Nothing wrong with that, seriously. I'm just telling you guys, we are actually using firewood and charcoal as a medium of cooking there, because not all of us are having a stove, electric stove or gas stove, so we are using the primitive ways. And as you can see here, I'm cooking. This is actually our old house. I refuse to like demolish it because this has a lot of memory. So yeah, it's fun. So this is the way we cook it. Literally, we use any dried firewood to cook our meal. What else? Okay, so let's talk about the tuob. The tuob actually is the term, means like to steam or to smoke. That is, yeah, more on smoke, to smoke, like you're smoking a sausage. Well, yeah, we started by, no, we don't start it by. First, let me introduce you what is the purpose of this. Okay, tuob is actually a healing practice, and most especially in Panay regions. It is believed to heal all kinds of illnesses and help you recover faster, especially if you just gave birth. For those mother who just gave birth, it helps them to heal their wounds faster and make them stronger faster. So what else? Because like tuob, actually they say it also helps you to perspire. That's why all your toxins was being flushed out in your body. Sounds cool, huh? So I actually did it and experienced it myself as well, and I'm gonna show you how they do it, how we do it. I participated, guys. Okay, so first I go with them. We gather all this kind of leaves, crazy leaves that I never like really know, but we have 7 types of leaves. The leaves that I've only known is bamboo, the pomelo leaves, and there's this leaves that they call alimpon. The smell is somewhat like oregano, but the leaves is like long and is very like, it has hair, like white hair, same like as oregano. And another thing, there's a lot, so actually there's 7 and I can only remember 3. Yeah, so anyway guys, it's like that. We will boil it, and then after boiling it, we will take away all those leaves, we will drain it. That's what we're going to use for tuob. So we started by the boiled water from those leaves. I'm going to use it as a bath water, so I'm going to shower using that water of boiled leaves. Actually the smell is very fragrant. Oh yeah, before I forget, what makes it fragrant is the lemongrass stalks, literally. Yeah, now I remember, lemongrass. And so after showering, they will ask me to sit down in a chair specifically made of bamboo, because bamboo have a slit in it, so there's space actually for the steam and smoke to pass. So they will cover me with a blanket, and then they will put a live charcoal in a fireproof pan, and then they will top those boiled leaves, and they will position it under the chair where I'm sitting at, and then they're going to like smoke me there. as I cover my whole body, but leaving the seat or like under my, you know, where I'm sitting is like not covered with blankets. So literally all those smoke there is very, very hot. It's kind of like, you know, embarrassing to tell you guys, but it's literally like that, like the smoke really passed there. And believe it or not, guys, after that, okay, I started to feel better. My breathing actually become lighter. You know why? Because guys, if just in case you don't know, last year I suffered severe pneumonia. So I told my doctor, like, doc, if possible, don't admit me here. I'm going back to Philippines so that I can recover faster. And it's a very good move for me to do that, I think, because like within just 2 weeks being there in Guimaras, literally I recovered. And then when I do my x-ray again, my god, it's just like a miracle. Like, it's gone and I'm healed and I'm so happy about it. And so yeah, that's all about the tulog. So more of practices as well, they also do this while you are being in tulog, they also make hampul. Is like a compress on the forehead, but it's made of fresh guayabano leaves, if you know that. Like, seven, guys, take note, it must be seven, okay, must be seven numbers. It must be like odd, not even. So this seven days and then tie it on your forehead like that. Or sometimes we have this kasla, I don't know in English, where we also hampul this, and then you will relieve with your headache if you are having one. And also, what else? Lana, we also have the lana. So lana is actually made of coconut oil. It's organic one. When we say organic one, we grate our own coconut and then we squeeze it and then we slowly cook it in the fire until we have the oil. And that oil, we will put it in a bottle. Inside that bottle, there are some kinds of roots actually. I don't know, guys, what are the name of the roots, but there's a lot of type of roots there. And it is believed that if that bottle of oil like overflowing, to say there's an aswang, and an aswang is, you know, another type of story. But yeah, that is the tulog, guys. And maybe if you visit Guimaras one day, why not try to experience that, just for experience, okay? So yeah, I think I'm gonna end my video right here. And if you want to see more of the Guimaras Island, actually I posted 3 parts of Guimaras video. You can scroll it down to see the farms, the detail about the mushroom farm, the grape farms, the windmill, the pagata, and everything. So you can just go there, guys, and check it out. And once again, thank you so much for stopping by, and I really appreciate that. I'm gonna make a quick shout out to my friends, Van. Thank you so much. Like, you are always be the first one to, like, really boom, the moment I upload my video, you are there to watch it, and I really appreciate that. Georgia, thank you so much for, like, promoting, help me promote my channel as well, sharing my videos. I didn't expect that. Georgia is actually we're not the closest growing up as childhood, because like we're moving from places to places, but we recognize each other by face. We don't hang out together as youth growing up, but now I think like we are more connected. Really, I appreciate that. Thank you so much. And also to my other social media friends, like Eunice, hello, Estrada, JR, Mike, hello, Linda, and a lot of you guys that I can't remember because I don't have much time. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching these videos, and stay tuned again, guys, for the next video. And by the way, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and please that bell button as well, so that you will get notified each time I upload new video each week. And see you guys.